So many of them. More than I wasn't expecting. Sort of lined up. And I felt like I could have categorized them, but I'd have been partially, completely, like absolutely wrong. And I have what can only be described as a crippling addiction to being right, and I'm trying to retrace the steps of a footless thought, and it's not easy, it never wasn't, everything isn't, they've left too much space in between the breadcrumbs. Am I writing right? I loathe not knowing things, but I wish I enjoyed the act of learning more. I believe I've given up on trying to make sense, but I also believe that I might be a nihilist, and I'm pretty sure that my right index finger is a communist, and that my left middle finger is an anarchist, and that my balled up fist is suspicious of skepticism, and that the duality of opposites is the most insignificantly significant nugget of thoughtfulness to have ever been dropped into this bottomless well of relativity that echoes force pelvises to tingle, and suggestion is a forceful lover. It seduces reason out of bad ideas. Discomfort is my only muse. Comfort is alone sometimes, sometimes not. Am I being productive enough? Is this metacognition shit productive? Am I wasting time the way that normal people waste time? Yes, I am thinking at you as you do at me, and I can feel it. I think if I knew what the fuck it was supposed to feel like, and why do I find myself falling into jealousy over and over and over again and loving every gluttonous moment of it? Why am I so envious of suffering? I think that I've developed a fetish for empathy. Is this what evolving feels like? Why is every question posed in the form of an answer? Why is vice versa vice versa-ish. If you still understand this, then you can fall in love with the version of me that wrote this, but he never really existed, and I only get erections from unconventional ideas, and I don't know where my mind is going, but I kind of like it, and I kind of don't, and I'll kind of go with it, and I kind of won't. And yesterday I was reminded of how insignificant I was, but today I still woke up with a sense of urgency. I am so greedy about my selflessness, so aware of my oblivion. Last Saturday morning I tried playing limbo with a strip of sunlight that sliced through my bedroom wall, and the music was dangling from the blades of the ceiling fan, and I don't even have a fucking ceiling fan yet. I bent over backwards. I still got shown on. Some things you just have to go through. I am trying to be present or up present or presented as such. I am aware of breath. I swear I am in the moment. I have let it be. I have let it go. My left shoulder blade is an old yogi. My left lung always votes for the lesser of two evils. My right lung is a staunch conservative, and I can't imagine how the fuck it breathes. My left foot is a libertarian. My right thumb is a poor judge of character. It keeps sticking up for all the wrong reasons. My brain is a negligent pet owner. My scalp is a shoddy ozone layer. My right testicle is a devout Hindu. It is regressing on the wheel of samsara. It was a SeaWorld executive in its previous life. See, my left testicle considers itself agnostic, and the tip of my penis, y'all, the tip of my penis still recites portions of the Torah sometimes, and I was awake when I nightmared about a future where everybody's belly buttons had been converted into USB ports, and even when they were all plugged in, like literally plugged into the same social networks, we still couldn't get along, and my hands are colonial imperialists, and my heart is a conceited God sitting in its ivory ribcage, convinced that everything is eager for its pulsating approval. Is this the stuff that stuff is made from? And how many atoms does it take to build a god? And how many gods does it take to start a war? And how many wars does it take to build a culture? And how many overlapping cultures does it take to qualify something as being diverse? And is this the stuff that, if this is the stuff that all stuff is made from, then what's the difference, and what does that have to do with subtraction? See, the other morning while standing on a crowded train in the eerily silent beginning of a lengthy delay, without even the slightest hint of a mechanical hiss, I swear I could hear somebody's inner child crying. Whimpering at first, and then sobbing, then weeping, then wailing, and by the time that the train started moving again, the crying was so loud, like the shriek of a hyperventilating raptor, that it domino affected everybody else's inner children to start crying too. But my inner child was just standing there inside of me, feeling an angry sort of sympathy, contemplating how the number 13 is still unlucky after all these years. Thank you.